Yeah, we're heading into March break, but now we've been told that now we have an extended March break, up to 3 weeks. So how do we keep the kids active and keep their minds active?
Yes, that's the key. Ruth Rumack is back, Director of Education, Ruth Rumack's Learning Space. So good to see you. You have a ton of ideas.
Tons of ideas.
First up, make a schedule.
We have to start there. We have to start with keeping some type of routine, something similar to what they do at school. So potentially looking at an activity, maybe 45 minutes and then a 15-minute break. And these breaks are really important to be outside, to be active. Now, if you can't go outside to a, you know, a park or something like that, but you can go on your balcony, get a breath of fresh air, run up and down the stairs, anything to keep that adrenaline going or the energy going. And then keep those chunks of learning small but fun and enjoyable. So we've got lots of different things that you can do today, but structure is important for the parents as well as for the kids.
Do you let them get involved in the structure? Do you get them to pick the schedule?
Absolutely.
Okay. Oh,
I think that, you know, with some reason, because you don't want to dictate everything, but you can say, you know what, what does your school day look like? What is the favorite thing you do in the day? Maybe do that first. And then portion the rest of the day out accordingly. And it's different, you know, if you're a stay-at-home parent, or you will be at home, or maybe you won't be at home. So we have to also allow for different people, caregivers who may be coming in to work with the kids as well.
Okay, speaking of, incorporate some family fun.
Yes.
While learning a little baking, science,
math.
Okay, this is cool.
Baking is everything, because you can do math, you can talk about proportions, you can talk about fractions, measurements. One fun thing to do is to take, you know, a substance, this is just cornstarch, and you can look at how many do you think, this is a 1/8 of a cup.
Right.
How many 1/8 do you think will fit in? Let's see if we can get that out. You want to hold that?
Yeah,
it's math time, Frankie.
Yep.
Yeah.
Yep.
How many 1/8 will fit in 1/4?
Okay.
Give it a try.
I would say 2.
All right, give it a try. Let's see. Yes, there's one. And do another one.
Math is
Frankie's
hard.
So good at math.
And
ding, ding.
Exactly. You got it. Well done.
Well done.
Another thing that you can do is look at water displacement or proportions of water. So you might say, oh, look at this. Look at this little vessel. How many of these can we fit in there? And then how many do you think it will take to fill up a larger bowl? Or looking for things that fit the same amount but have a different shape. So, for example, you know, let's see. Oh, it's almost the same, but it doesn't really look the same, does it? So you can talk about the fact that liquid changes when it's in a container.
You could probably create a challenge between brothers and sisters and siblings, right?
And everybody gets their own station.
Right.
And then they're looking to see, you know, how many of each or what the water looks like. Those are for younger kids. But for the older kids, I think we're looking long-term, potentially. There are lots of things online that you can find, lots of worksheets, but of course you want to intersperse that with some hands-on, really more exciting things.
Yeah.
You could make a relay race in your home for math, set up a bunch of multiplication questions and have your children go around the house finding the questions, almost like a scavenger hunt. There are many, many things. Let's talk a little bit about, let's go back to the baking though, because it's not just math, it's science, it's reactions. If you take baking soda and vinegar, what is the reaction that's going to happen, right? Experiments, you can find tons of those online as well. But there's a language component and there's an executive functioning component, which means planning and executing a plan. So when you're asked to read a recipe, you want to make sure that you're reading the words carefully, you're looking at the amounts, you're double checking the amounts, you're following the instructions in a particular order. All of these things are really important skills that they may not be, you know, textbook based, but they're life based. And they're things that we need for every day.
Okay.
So baking is fabulous. We can move on to science.
What's happening with the egg?
I brought a raw egg. It's really raw.
Okay.
It's verified raw. And one of the things that we love to do in our house is the egg drop.
Okay.
And the egg drop is a challenge. Again, you can pit siblings against siblings if you want. You are going to find items around the house that will secure the egg.
So I can put it in this.
Put it in this fuzzy bag. You can put, we've got some styrofoam bubbles.
We can drop it there.
Yeah. We can put it on the foam. We can wrap it in tissue paper. Okay. Let your children go wild. And this is really a great thing for all ages. Go for it.
Two, one, egg drop.
Oh,
no yolk, it's raw.
No yolk.
We got cracking.
No yolk. So those are types of things that you can also even do some written component to, which is, what is your prediction? What do you think will happen? Make a list of the different materials that you can find around the house.
Almost like a science fair project.
Science fair project, exactly. Yeah. Draw it out. And you could do one every day, different one every day. Mm-hmm. I'm looking at, let's look at the boxes.
Yep.
The boxes are great if you have extra boxes, if anybody's ordering online these days. Mm-hmm. We've got buildup of boxes. Put out some tape, take some scissors, take some, you know, you rip it, you find objects around the house. A lot of these activities are building activities. You can do a challenge of how high can your box go or your tower go. Mm-hmm. Give them a limited number of supplies and figure out what amount of weight you can hold in that particular structure. Mm-hmm. So be creative. I mean, your kids are going to get a box and scissors and tape, and they're going to be busy for half an hour for
sure. Tell us about the books.
Books or novels, books or storybooks. I like the idea of a family book club. And the family book club is something that you might read together and then do questions or activities based on the book.
All great tips, considering how many days, you know, kids have already lost with the ongoing rolling strikes, and now with the extended March break. This is all news we can use, right, Frankie?
Keep their minds going.
Keep it
Ruth,
active.
Ruth, the learning guru, where do we find more information?
RuthRumack.com.
Thank you so much. We'll be back with more BT right after this.